Clear.
So let me start the presentation. Today we'll see okay, let us start today's class. This is one of the very important, today we are going to do some questions based on reasoning, and these are the questions which are, probably will pass in the any placement exams if you sit into that. And why we are doing reasoning or aptitude? Why the companies they take a entrance test related to the reasoning and the aptitude? The only reason behind that, because the knowledge and the work culture inside the company, they will torture you once you reach the company. They do not want that you have a complete knowledge of C, C++, because maybe that is not needed for them. But definitely they will check your logical brain, how you think about a particular problem, and if some sort of case study comes across you, how you deal with that particular situation. That is why they ask you this aptitude and reasoning. And I request you all to make yourself so strong in aptitude and reasoning. And if they are very easy, the only thing is the questions are very tricky. So if you know the trick, then you are able to solve the question very easily and very quickly. So let me start one of the very, very important topic of counting the squares. So everybody, I think everybody know about this thing. This is a chess board. Now my question is to all of you, to how to calculate the number of squares in this image. How many squares are there in this image? So let me ask to Mohammad Asif. Mohammad Asif, could you explain how many number of squares in this chessboard?
Sir, I think 75.
75. Oh, but I think these are the 8 rows and 8 columns. So
64.
okay, just if you are unmuting yourself now, you just first of all tell your name and then speak. Yes.
Sorry, Srishti sir. Sir, 64 into
64
8.
squares. Okay, see Srishti, now I will tell you, this is not 64, this is not 75,
Sir,
it is more than that. Ha, yeah, please.
सर अनुराग दिस साइड सर,
अनुराग,
64 स्क्वायर्स हैं एंड देन एक मेजर स्क्वायर 65 स्क्वायर होंगे सर।
ओह, 65 स्क्वायर्स, वेरी गुड। 65, 64 एंड 75, वी हैव थ्री आंसर्स। एनीबॉडी एल्स वांट टू टेल?
सर सौरभ दिस साइड।
सौरभ, यस।
सर 512।
हाउ मेनी?
512।
12।
सर 512।
512, 512, ओके। So let okay, now you just mute yourself all, and we'll see how many squares are there in this in this chessboard. So let me move forward. So see, if we are talking about the number of squares, you can count it like 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 8 into 8. So 64 must be there, and one is the 65. I think you forget about these two. This is also a one square. This is also a square. So this is also a square. This is also a square. And similarly, if you see broader, this is also a square. Similarly, this is also a square. So now it is clear in your mind. Definitely the answer would be, more than 64, 65, 75, maybe less than 512. We will see. But is there any systematic approach? This is very important. Is there any systematic approach how to calculate these number of squares? So this is what I am talking about today. See, there is a trick to count the number of squares in this. So first of all, you have to write the how many sizes of squares are possible in this particular chessboard. So yes, one by one, definitely. One by one or two by two size is also there. 3 by 3 size is also there, like this. 4 by 4 is there. 5 by 5, 6 by 6, 7 by 7, and 8 by 8 is there. Now, how many of them? It is counted 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is 8 by 8. So how many are up and up? How many are down? They are 8. So we can write 8 by 8 is 64. Similarly for 2 by 2. If we are talking about 2 by 2, so let me count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I am counting the 2 by 2, then 2 by 2 are 7 here in rows and 7 here in columns. So definitely they are 7 into 7, that is 49. Similarly, 3 by 3, if I count it 3 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Similarly, vertically 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 by 6, it is 36. Similarly, when we are talking about 4, they are 5. When we are talking about 5 by 5, they are 4. When we are talking about 6 by 6, they are 3. When we are talking about 7 by 7, they are 2. And when we are talking about 8 by 8, they are 1. So, and since the number of rows and columns are same, so 6 into 6, they are 36. And then 25, then 16, then 9, then 4 plus 1. Then what you have to do? You have to add all. So if we add them, they will give us 204. So it means in 8 by 8 chessboard, there are 204, you know, number of squares. So very easy. What you have to do? You have to first of all see how many, you know, kind of sizes are available. So by 1 by 1, 2 by 2, 3 by 3, 4 by 4, 5 by 5, 6 by 6, 7 by 7 and 8 by 8. And then you have to count the number of squares in the rows and the columns. So see, in the number of rows, they are 1, if we are talking about 1 by 1, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. And in the column, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's right. The 1 by 1 squares are 8 by 8, that is 64. If we are talking about 2 by 2, now you have to, for 2 by 2, just wait, the PowerPoint presentation is stopped. I will, you know, start it again. Okay, let me start it again. Right. Okay, so I think everybody understands this by, you know, counting this. So aapko karna kya hai, I will tell it again. What you have to do, you have to, you know, count the number of 1 by 1 squares in the rows and columns, and then you have to multiply. So kya ye, now the question arises whether there is some systematic, you know, way. Yes, this is a systematic way. And we can, you know, generalize this thing for all others. Like, if we have it, instead of 8 by 8 chessboard, if we have 5 by 5 chessboard, so what I have to do? Because chessboard may be of any, you know, any kind of numbers. So if we have 5 by 5 chessboard, then we have to take it up to 5 by 5. Otherwise, this is the relation for n by n chessboard. For n by n, you have to do the square of the n, then you have to do it, you know, subtract 1 1 1 till 1 will it will come reach to 1, and then you have to add all this. So this will give you the number of squares. So I think everybody understand. Then if somebody asks you how many squares are in 5x5 chessboard, so in 5x5 chessboard, okay, kaun batayega in 5x5 chessboard kitne honge squares? Very quickly, Anurag.
Sir, let me just count.
Okay, you just add it. आपको करना है क्या है? आपको क्या करना है? पांच का स्क्वायर, आपको पांच का स्क्वायर लिखो. पांच का स्क्वायर कितना होता है? 25. देखो पांच का स्क्वायर कितना होता है? 25. 25 में आपको 16 जोड़ना है, देन 9 जोड़ना है, देन 4 जोड़ना है, देन 1 जोड़ना है. आपको करना क्या था? एन स्क्वायर, एन माइनस वन स्क्वायर, एन. हाँ, तो कितना आया ये टोटल? इसको टोटल करके बताओ.
So 55.
So आपको एक चीज़ समझ में आ गई कि कितने भी नंबर ऑफ स्क्वेयर्स अगर आपको कैलकुलेट करने हो तो आपको सिंपल इन अ चेस बोर्ड होंगी. तो आपको करना क्या है? उसको ऐसे 20x20 का अगर आपसे कोई पूछ ले कि 20x20 का चेस बोर्ड है, हाउ मेनी देयर आर यू नो नंबर ऑफ स्क्वायर्स, सो वेरी इजीली 65, इट इज 65 नॉट 55, इसको चेक करना, ये 65 होगा. एंड सिमिलरली फॉर 20x20 इफ यू वांट टू कैलकुलेट द नंबर ऑफ स्क्वायर्स इट कम्स टू बी 2870. So this how you know you can easily calculate the number of squares. If anybody have any doubt till this point, sir, you can ask me. Yeah.
Sir, 55
bhi
aa raha
hai. 25 jama 16 jama 9 jama 4 jama 1. 16 aur 4 20, 20 aur 10 30. Okay, maybe it is wrongly written. It is 55. You just corrected. It is 55, right? So this is a way, you know, how to calculate the number of squares in a particular figure, particularly in the chessboard kind of thing. So किसी को doubt तो नहीं है इसमें? याश भी कह रहा हूँ?
No sir.
Right. So let me quickly move towards the next topic. This is one which is you know very frequently asked in the reasoning and aptitude exams. So let me proceed further. Yeah. This is again a very important question. How many squares are there? So first of all, what you have to do? You have to count the number of ones. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So 24, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So these are one by one, 24. If we are talking about 2 by 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So 13 are 2 by 2, 14, 4 by 4 ke 1, 4, and 4 by 4 ka only 1. So total number of squares are just you have to add them. So this is how you know you can do, this is a trick. So that's why this is asked to you in the reasoning and aptitude exams. How many number of squares are there, you just have to count it. Basically this will use your, you know, logical brain. So until or unless you did this question prior to, you know, sitting in the exam for a placement, you will not solve it in the specified time that will given to you. That is 30 minutes or 30, around 40 minutes. So I'll advise you all to, you know, just make yourself good in aptitude and reasoning. And I am doing, you know, live streaming on every Sunday, particularly on this reasoning and aptitude. If you want, I'll share a link with you. You just, you know, learn with me how to, you know, do reasoning and aptitude quickly. So let me do something on cubes. How many cubes are there? Okay, let me ask you people first. This is called. Kya kehte hain bhai sahab isko? What is this name? Its name?
Sir, I'm Rob. Rubik's cube.
So इसमें मुझे बताओ कि कितने नंबर ऑफ क्यूब्स हैं अनुराग
सर. 9 × 9.
9 × 9, वेरी गुड. कैसे निकाला भाई 9 × 9? 81 क्यूब्स है इसके अंदर.
नहीं सर, एक
मिनट. हाँ,
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
देखो इसको हाँ बताओ बताओ फटाफट अनुराग प्लीज.
सर 54 होंगे क्यूब.
54 क्यूब. ओके यार, यहाँ से देखो 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 9, 9, 18, 9, 9, 27 ही नज़र आ रहे हैं मुझे तो. क्यूब तो यही है ना. अच्छा, उसके अलावा ये क्यूब ये भी होंगे. राइट राइट राइट. 2x2 के भी होंगे, 4x4 के भी होंगे. सो ओके, विल सी हाउ मेनी क्यूब्स आर देयर. कैन एनीबडी वांट टू स्पीक? कोई और बोलना चाह रहा है? ओके नो. So let me move forward. How many cubes are there? Okay, we'll see the trick. See, we have to do the same thing that we did it in, you know, while calculating the number of squares. We have to do the same thing over here. Now what we have to see here, first of all, we have to check how many sizes of cubes may be possible here. One is 1 by 1 size cube where the side is 1. Another is, you know, 2 with the side 2. And another one is, you know, the side 3. So 1 by 1 by 1 are how many? Okay, just you have to multiply it 3, and in the whole cube it is 27, because 3 is like here and 3 is like here. So total number of cubes just wait. I'm just sharing it again. Okay, let me share it again. Let me come to the views. Yeah. So this is 1 by 1 by 1. That is 3. So whole is 27 because you have to. What we did here is we take the cube of this 3 into 3 into 3. That is 27. Similarly for 2 by 2 by 2, they are only 2 because 2 by 2 by 2. If you checked it on the one face, they are only 2. One is this and upward along the backwards. They are 2. So that is 8 because you have to do the cube of that. Similarly. For 3 by 3 by 3, it is 1. So the, in the whole cube, it is 1. 1 cube is 1. So the total number of cubes are, you know, 27 plus 8 plus 1, that is 36. So the whole trick is here, the trick that you have to remember is you have to, you know, first of all, check how many kinds of cubes may be possible in this. One is 1 by 1 by 1, this kind of cube. Another is 2 by 2 by 2, and another is 3 by 3 by 3. So what you have to do with the first one, you have to now 1 by 1 by 1 are how many? 1 by 1 by 1 are upwards along backward. So you have to see the, you know, faces of 1 by 1 by 1. How many faces are there are visible? That is 1 1 1. So 3 faces are there. That is, it is mentioned 3. And then you have to do the cube of 3, that is 27. Similarly, for 2 by 2 by 2, what you have to do? For 2 by 2 by 2, only 2 surfaces, you know, are visible. If we are talking about the 2 by 2 by 2, this is 1 and 1 is this. Only 2 faces we are observing. So, means by 2 by 2 by 2, we have only 2 surfaces visible. So, that is why we are taking it 2 by 2 by 2. And for 3 by 3 by 3, only since only one surface is, you know, hidden, not visible, that is not visible, is 1. So that is why we are taken it 3 by 3 by 3, that is 1. So the total number of cubes, the only trick you have to learn is for 1 by 1 by 1, you have to take the 3. For 2 by 2 by 2, you have to take it 2. And for 3 by 3 by 3, you have to take it 1. And then you have to cube them and add them. That will give you 36. So let us see here. In inner cube size, okay, 1 by 1 by 1 is 4. Is 4 since it is, you know, now this is not. It has four layers. It is not a 3 layer. This one is a 3 layer. So this one is a 4 layer. For this 1 by 1 by 1 are 4. And that is 64, and 2 by 2 by 2 is 3, that is 27. Then 3 by 3 by 3 is, you have to do it 2, that is 8. Then 4 by 4 by 4 is 1, that is 1, and you have to add them. So total number of cubes are in 4 by 4 is 100. So the only way, if we generalize this concept, how many, you know, number of cubes are there, then this is a formula. For 4 by 4 by 4, you have to start it from 4, then 3, then 2, and then 1. If I ask you from 5 by 5 cube, then it is 5 cube plus 4 cube plus 3 cube plus 2 cube plus 1 cube. This is of counting the number of squares. If you want to calculate the number of squares, then you have to do the square. And if you want to do calculate the number of cubes, then you have to use this trick. So this is, you know, and what is the pattern here? What if there is a 4 dimension? Definitely for the 4 dimension, there is another pattern, that is 4 cube, that is n4 plus n minus 1 4, same like this, like in n cross n, this is a pattern, and for n cross n cross n, this is a pattern. So what happens if it is a 4 dimension? Although the 4 dimension is not possible, that is why there is no formula. But hypothetically, if somebody asks you, what will happen if there is a fourth dimension, then definitely you have to, you know, solve it like this. So this is something. If anybody have any problem in calculating the number of moves, you may ask me. Or otherwise, Mohammad Asif, समझ में आया बेटा आपको?
Yes sir, yes sir.
कैसे करना है जरा? Can you could you explain again?
Yeah, sure sir. So you tell ki 2D geometry के अंदर we take a square actually. Whatever we are given the numbers, we have to put the formula of n square plus n minus 1 square plus n minus 2 square and up to 1. जब तक करना हो जाए. For in 3D geometries like we have cube. We have to use the formula n cube plus n minus 1 cube plus n minus 2 cube and up to 1. N जो होगा यहाँ पर number of जैसे हम अभी आपने जो पिछला example है उसमें number of 3 columns 3 rows थी. तो we can say जितने number of columns या rows होंगे n की value वही हो जाएगी.
Right.
In this case it is 4 by 4 dimension. So we can take 4 as n, then 4 cube plus 3 cube plus 2 cube plus 1 cube. And up to so.
Right. So okay. Can anybody else want to say something? Yes, Anurag. आपको समझ में आया?
Yes, sir. Sir, एक छोटा सा question है. Like हम तो three side देख रहे हैं sir. Top view, front view and side view. But back side के जो three portions हैं like behind का, bottom का और वो. वो भी कंसीडर नहीं होगा सर?
वो भी कंसीडर हो गए इस ट्रिक के अंदर, वो भी कंसीडर हो गए. सी 1 by 1 by 1 के कितने हैं? एक मिनट, लेट मी आंसर योर क्वेश्चन. सी 1 by 1 by 1 के कितने हैं? तो ये 4 बेसिकली सरफेसेस ही तो काउंट करी हैं. एक तो 1 by 1 by 1 के, एक तो देख ये हो गई 1 2 3 4, ठीक है. एक इधर हो गई 1 2 3 4, ठीक है. और एक ऊपर हो गई 1 2 3 4, ठीक है ना. बेसिकली ये 4 × 4 × 4 64 कैसे आया? 1 by 1 के तूने ये 3 फेसेस तेरे को नजर आ रहे हैं ना. 1 by 1 के कितने फेसेस नजर आ रहे हैं? 1 2 3 3 फेसेस नजर आ रहे हैं. तो और इस 1 by 1 के इसमें एक्चुअली है कितने? 1 by 1 by 1 के रोज में कितने हैं? ऐसे काउंट करो, हाउ मेनी आर देयर इन नंबर ऑफ इन द वन रो? 4 1 2 3 4, ठीक है. 2 by 2 by 2 के कितने हैं एक रो में? 1 2 और ये 3. दैट्स व्हाई 2 by 2 by 2 के तूने एक रोज में कैलकुलेट कर लिया और उसको 3 से मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया ना, तो वो पूरे क्यूब के आ जाएंगे.
ओके सर.
ऐसे ही 3 by 3 by 3 के मुझे बता एक रो में कितने नजर आ रहे हैं तेरे को? 1 2 only 2. दैट इज व्हाई तूने 2 by 2 by 2 को 3 से मल्टीप्लाई कर दिया. तब क्योंकि 3 से क्यों मल्टीप्लाई किया? बिकॉज इट इज अ 3 डायमेंशन फिगर ना. तो हम एक ही सर्फिस पे काम कर रहे हैं. और उस पहले हमने क्या किया था, देखो नंबर ऑफ स्क्वेयर्स जब हमने कैलकुलेट किया था तो क्या किया था हमने? नंबर ऑफ स्क्वेयर्स में भी तो यही ट्रिक लगाई थी हमने. क्या किया था? किया था कि कितने एक रो में कितने वो हैं, 1 by 1 के कितने हैं. तो 1 by 1 के कितने थे? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8, 8 और 8. तो 8 और 8 कितना हो गया? 64. समझ में आया? क्योंकि हमने फिर इसको काउंट नहीं किया, बस हमने रोज में देखने हैं कितने हैं और उसको डबल कर देना अगर ये 2D है तो. और अगर ये 3D है तो सेम काम 3D में 3 बार मल्टीप्लाई कर देना. आई थिंक नाउ इट इज कंफर्टेबल.
यस सर.
राइट. जैसे 2 by 2 के 7 कैसे हैं देख, ये दिखाए थे यहाँ पे 1 2 3, सॉरी दोबारा करते हैं, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. तो 7 है तो 7 by 7 × 7 by 7 कर दोगे तो वो 49 जो है वो टोटल आ जाएंगे. ठीक है. एनी अदर एनीबडी? साक्षी, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेरी? समझ में आ गया साक्षी? ओके, एनीबडी एल्स हु आ गया? ओके, वेरी गुड साक्षी, वेरी गुड. एनीबडी एल्स हु इज प्रेजेंट इन द क्लास एंड वांट टू आस्क एनीथिंग? और शैल आई मूव फॉरवर्ड? सी, अगर आप पूछोगे नहीं क्वेश्चन तो आपके दिमाग में जो कन्फ्यूजन रहेगी वो आपको बड़ी परेशान करेगी आगे. ओके, आई थिंक नोबडी हैव नो प्रॉब्लम. तो ये सब कुछ समझ में आ गया होगा आई थिंक. आसिफ, वो डाउट भी क्लियर हो गया तेरे को जो थोड़ा सा डाउट था कि हमने ये 4 कैसे लिया? हमने क्या किया, 1 by 1 by 1 के ये चेक कर लिए कि कितने हैं. 1 एक रो में देखने हैं बस तेरे को, एक सरफेस को पकड़ के देखना है. वन बाय वन के कितने हैं, वन टू थ्री फोर, तूने फोर का क्यूब कर दिया। टू बाय टू के कितने हैं एक रो में, एक दो तीन, तीन का क्यूब कर दिया। और थ्री बाय थ्री के कितने हैं, थ्री बाय थ्री का खाली एक और एक ये दो, तो दो का क्यूब कर दिया। और फोर बाय फोर के कितने हैं, एक ही सरफेस, खाली एक सरफेस को देखना है, तो फोर बाय फोर के कितने हैं, एक ही है, तो एक से मल्टीप्लाई और एट द एंड तेरे को ऐड कर देना। डन?
यस सर।
ओके ओके ओके। सो नाउ 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 लेट मी डू समथिंग मोर, एंड दिस इज अगेन अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग। हाउ मेनी ट्रायंगल्स आर देयर, इसके अंदर कितने ट्रायंगल्स है, कैन यू काउंट? ओके, कौन बताएगा, कौन बताएगा जी इसको? ट्रायंगल्स कितने हैं इसके अंदर? ओके, जस्ट डू इट योरसेल्फ। ओके, अदरवाइज आई विल एक्सप्लेन। सी, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आपको करना क्या है, यू हैव टू काउंट द नंबर ऑफ वंस द ट्रायंगल व्हिच इज फाउंड बाय द, यू नो, वन, इफ आई से दिस इज अ वन यूनिट, सो 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 then 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So 16 are the, जो एक एक के बने हैं। दूसरा ट्रैंगल जो ये वाला बनेगा दो दो साइडों से, वो कितने होंगे, सात। और तीन तीन वालों कितने बनेंगे, तीन तीन वाले तीन बनेंगे और एक चार वाला बनेगा। सी, दोबारा देखो इसमें कितनी साइडों के ट्रैंगल बन सकते हैं। एक तो एक, अगर इसको आपको आपको ऐसे समझना चाहिए, सी दिस इज द वन यूनिट। ओके, लेट मी टेक अ पेन क्विकली। दिस इज द वन यूनिट वाले काउंट कर लो वो, और उसके बाद फिर आपको दो यूनिट वाले काउंट करने हैं, फिर आपको तीन यूनिट वाले काउंट करने हैं, और फिर आपको चार यूनिट वाले काउंट करने हैं। तो बहुत ही आसान है, वन यूनिट वाला एक दो तीन चार पाँच छः सात आठ नौ दस ग्यारह बारह तेरह चौदह पंद्रह सोलह, सो दिया सोलह। और टू बाय टू वाले कितने हैं, दो साइड वाले कितने हैं, एक दैन दो दैन तीन दैन चार दैन पाँच एंड देन छः और एक ये उल्टा बना हुआ है सात, सो दो बाय दो के सात हैं। तीन बाय तीन के कितने थे, वन एंड टू एंड थ्री, ओनली तीन। और चार बाय चार का कितना, खाली एक, तो टोटल आ गया 27। सो आई थिंक दिस इज अगेन, कैन यू जनरेट अ सिस्टमेटिक फॉर दिस, कैन यू जनरेट अ सिस्टमेटिक फॉर दिस, कैसे कर? देखो सिंपल, वन बाय वन के कितने थे, अगर एक फेस को देखें, ओके आई ओपन इट अगेन। सी, वन बाय वन के कितने थे, अभी हम ओके सी वन बाय वन के कितने थे, आई विल रिपीट इट अगेन। हमें वही टेक्निक लगानी है जो हमने सीखी है। आपको वन बाय वन के कितने हैं, अगर आप वन बाय वन के गिनो तो एक रो में गिन लो, आप रो और कॉलम में, जस्ट टेकिंग पेन, या वन बाय वन के कितने कितने वो हैं, सी वन वन बाय वन के सी वन 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 के कितने हैं, वन टू थ्री फोर, तो आपको करना क्या है, फोर इंटू फोर मल्टीप्लाई बाई फोर, डेट इज 16। टू बाई टू के कितने हैं, बट दिस इज नॉट अ ट्रिक, यू कैन यू नो अप्लाई हर। सो टू बाई टू के लिए वन टू ओनली टू एंड वन इन बिटवीन दिस, सो दिस इज एन स्क्वायर एंड अनदर फॉर अनदर वट यू डू डेट इज अगेन एन स्क्वेयर माइनस वन, दैट इज टू बाय टू के कितनी साइड्स हैं, एक एक दो और तीन, तो तीन 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 का मतलब हुआ थ्री इंटू थ्री माइनस वन, दैट विल गिव्स यू एट, बट नो हेयर टू बाय टू के हैं वन टू। सो यू नो दिस इज अप टू यू, यू कैन जनरेट अ फॉर्मूला ऑल्सो फॉर दिस काइंड ऑफ फिगर, अदरवाइज यू कैन काउंट इट। So I'll advise you to just count it, that is better rather than to generate a formula. So similarly here, this is an again one activity. Now you have to calculate the number of triangles in this figure. So again, you have to first of all count the single one, 1, 2, 3, 4 and multiplied by 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 by 4, that is 16. 4 by 4 is 16. Then for the area 2, for area 2 means this. In 1 it is 4, in 1 it is 1 and 2 and 1 and 2 only, 1 and 2. So 2 and not 2, they are area 2 are 4. One is this, another one is this, and another one is this, and another one is this. So 4. So 4 by 4, again 16. And with the area 8, with the area 4, like this, it is 1, 2, 3, 4. With the area 4, how many are there? With the area 4, 4 unit, the triangle with the 4, okay. The triangle with the 4 is 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, there are total, you know, 8. If you consider triangle like this, 1, then this one, 2, right, then this one, 3, then this one, 4, and 4 others. Because on one side there are 2, see, 1 and 2. Similarly, on this side, it is 1 and 2. Similarly, on this side, it is 1 and 2. Similarly, on this side, this is 1 and this is 2. So, total 8 are there. And what about the area 8? Those with area 8, the triangle which have the area 8. How it is possible? Triangle with the area 8, it means this. This is it. No, this one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
6. I think diagonal one.
Yeah.
From one column
yeah.
to second.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. In which there are 8 triangles. So one is this. One is this. So there are 4. So total are 644. So this is also, you know, one of the trick which is asked in the exam. Maybe asked to you in the exam. So the only advice from my side is you must have, you know, prior experience before sitting into the exam to save the time. Otherwise, most of the students, they did the practice prior to, you know, sit in the exam. So this is the only advice from my side. You just do the practice, and practice makes the man perfect only. And then you can, you know, succeed in to crack that placement exam. Otherwise, it is going to be a very difficult for you in your life. So with this hope, I think this is enough for the today's class. If you have some doubts,